All right, so we're gonna get straight into it. This is my roasted shallot and garlic mashed potatoes, my ultimate mashed potatoes. I have two shallots here and about 20 cloves of garlic. So we're gonna, you know, fix this up and pop it in the oven and roast them off really, really well. I'm using two of these packet things, and I believe they equate to a bulb of garlic. So if you can't find them, just make sure you get two bulbs of garlic. All right, so I'm adding my shallots and my garlic to parchment paper and aluminum foil. Y'all know I don't put aluminum foil directly on food, depending on what I'm doing or making. Next, I added some salt and some oil. You want to wrap it up and pop it in the oven in about 375 for about 25 minutes. And they should be nice and caramelized and soft and ready to go. So this is how I wrap it up. I always put a barrier of parchment paper before I put aluminum foil. This is my potato right here, and I'll describe better in my description box as to the types of potatoes that you should not use, or, you know, just use what you prefer. This is what the garlic looks like and the shallots. And you want to smash it up. A lot of people put it in the food processor. I'm not trying to dirty no other, you know, big dishes. So I just smashed it with the fork. It was nice and tender. It smells amazing. Like, look at this. This is going in your mashed potatoes. Like, come on. So this is how it looks. And now I'm going to show you guys the rest of the ingredients. Of course, I have a lot of chives here. It's about a quarter cup of chives. I'm probably not going to use all of it, but most of it. I also have sour cream to this pot. I'm going to add a half a stick of butter and half and half. Now, in my humblest opinion, I just feel like half and half is like the perfect middle. I feel like the milk is too light and heavy cream is just too heavy. And so I decided to go with half and half. That's what I've always used. Usually I do mash my potatoes in the hot pot, but I wanted y'all to see what I'm doing. I don't have the best lighting in my house. I am working on that. So to this, you just want to smash it a little bit just to get it to move around some. Then I'm going to add the whole entire thing. Yes, I know somebody looking like, oh Lord, she done ruined it. Y'all know potatoes soak up a lot. Look at this roasted, oh my goodness, look at this roasted shallot and garlic, you guys. And I'm telling you right now, the minute it hits the milk with the potatoes, the smell that hits your nose is ridiculous. Like, I can't. And so in real time, I'm gonna let y'all watch me mash the potatoes. I'm not gonna skip, I'm not going to speed it up. I want y'all to see that in real time, the potatoes actually soaked up all of that liquid and it's not soupy. So this is what it looks like, and it just looks great. So now I'm going to add my chives down in here as much as you want, you know, or as little. And then I'm gonna also add my sour cream. Next, I'm also going to add salt and pepper. I didn't add much other seasonings in here because it just doesn't need it. You know, you have the butter, the chives, the roasted garlic. You know, it was tons of garlic. And, you know, the shallots. And it's so, so, so delicious. And this recipe, I know it's a lot more work, but you're only making this once a year. You know, do I make potatoes like this all the time? Heck no. Don't nobody got time for that. No. But this right here is super delicious and definitely going to be a crowd pleaser if you make it for Thanksgiving. Look how creamy and delicious this looks. Like, look how creamy this mashed potato is. Also, when I was boiling my mashed potatoes, you guys, I boiled it. I put it on the stove and ignored it and just let it boil forever. I finished it with some more shallots on top, some more roasted garlic, some butter, and look at that. Can you imagine bringing that out and putting it on your table while everyone's standing there? Anyway, I love you guys so much. I finally got this recipe out. Y'all are so spoiled, but I love it. And I'll catch y'all on my next video. Bye. Thank you.